So we saw the big question, what is the difference between social influence and selection? Which one of the two is happening? Are both happening? Now, it's very difficult for us to go ahead and look at the real world data set of friendships and ask this question. If we ask this question of, can we have some very concrete data set where this experiment can actually be conducted and the facts be unraveled? There was one such data set which gave some very promising observations. So our motive for this video chunk is to understand this piece of research on Wikipedia. Okay, let me now motivate the concept by explaining how Wikipedia works, number one, and number two, by explaining what one means by similarity measure. These two are important for us to go any further. Okay, so how does Wikipedia work? Wikipedia basically is a blank slate. You can basically, anyone can go write anything on Wikipedia. For example, you can open the Wikipedia entry of India, edit it. If you think some information is incorrect there, delete it and add the right content that you think is right. And if someone else thinks what you have entered is wrong, they will come and edit it and change it to what they think is right. This goes on and on. One frequently asked question is, can we really trust such a database where anyone can come and enter anything? Yeah, very intriguing, but it is known to be true that when a lot of people get together and start discussing and debating, when they have conflicts of their ideas, true knowledge is known to emerge. Initially, of course, there will be some false information here and there, but a lot of people watching it will converge to the right answer. So Wikipedia is actually believed to be very trustworthy these days. That's about Wikipedia. But what happens in the background of Wikipedia? There are many people who will be coming and editing it. If there is conflicts on their belief of what should be put and what should not be put, they talk in the background with each other. And the background talking is also visible for all of us. They are called user talk page. One can click on this tab and then take a look at what all discussions they have about the content. Now, this big data set is available to our disposal and one can conduct any kind of research on this data set. I am now going to explain one such research which actually helped us understand the interplay between social influence and selection. As I told you just now, I helped you understand how Wikipedia works. That was the first prerequisite. The second prerequisite is understanding what one means by a similarity measure. So let me motivate what is a similarity measure now. So let me define what is a similarity measure. It is actually quite intuitive. Let me motivate it with a good example. Assume I like the following dishes. Okay, I like upma, let's say idli, dosa, pizza, and let's say fruit punch. These are the five things that I like. Okay, upma, idli, all those things are South Indian dishes. And let's say my friend Priya, she likes pizza, burger, let's say pasta and idli. Okay, these four things. As you can see, we don't have a lot of commonalities, but we like pizza and idli. That is common between both of us. So what I do is, in the denominator I put the total number of items that we like, whatever I like and whatever Priya likes. Both put together, as you can see, is 7 items, out of which we both like 2 items. So I say the similarity measure between me and Priya is 2/7. This is what we mean by similarity measures. Now I am going to use this on my Wikipedia data set that I was telling you, right? So what do? There are two people, two authors who are editing Wikipedia pages randomly here and there. Let's say I am editing the Wikipedia entry of India and let's say Chennai floods and Wikipedia entry on iPhone 8 and things like that. different Wikipedia pages I'm editing. And a friend of mine, let's say Peter, is editing Wikipedia pages, again some other Wikipedia pages, some 10 other Wikipedia pages. The similarity measure between me and Peter is the total number of Wikipedia pages that we both are editing, total number of unique Wikipedia pages that we both are editing in the denominator. And in the numerator, we write those Wikipedia pages we both have edited, just like the similarity measure that I defined between me and Priya. The similarity measure between me and Peter on Wikipedia is total number of Wikipedia articles that we both have edited in the numerator divided by the total possible unique Wikipedia pages that we have edited, both put together. That's in the denominator. This gives a good measure of how similar we both are on our Wikipedia editing transactions. So now that you understand what is how Wikipedia works, and you also understand the definition of similarity measure, I'm going to use these two things in answering the big question of social influence versus selection. Okay, so here it goes. I'll do the following. I look at two people who have spoken to each other on Wikipedia. I told you, people do talk in the talk pages in the background. If I observe that two people have spoken to each other, please note, I have a data set here. In that data set, I observe if two people have spoken to each other. If let's say two people, let's say Rama and Prem have spoken to each other on the Wiki talk page, then what I do is I plot this. What is the plot? The plot is the following. This is my y-axis, this is my x-axis. I will see when exactly they spoke. Let me call that time t equals 0. And I'll observe what were they doing before and what were they doing, what did they do after this time equals 0. What do I mean by that? Let me define what is the x and y-axis properly. On the y-axis, I will put I'll put the their similarity measure. Okay, their similarity measure is given by, let's say, 0.005, 0.010, so on and so forth, 0.015, so on up to, let's say, 0.00040. Okay, I'm doing this on the y-axis. This is my similarity and this is my time. I repeat, Rama and Prem have started editing some Wikipedia articles, and their similarity measure I'm seeing when they first spoke. This line denotes the time when they first spoke. By spoke, let's be clear, I mean first time they spoke on the talk page, on the talk page. And I observe what was their similarity measure before and what is their similarity measure after. It was observed that the plot looks something like this. It looks like this. Let me correct this. It just goes steep. It just goes like this. That's it. Point to note is the steep increase and further increase, and then it becomes sort of constant. What is happening here? Let's just pause and observe. Let's revise. Time, similarity measure. Rama and Prem. Their similarity measure was, see, this is time when they started, let's say some few days before, and the first time they met, this probably is some minus something, minus 100, minus 200 or whatever is the scale, okay, and the time when they first met, and then time t equals 100, and then 200, and then 300, so on. whatever you want, 200 minutes or 200 seconds, or you can have any scale here. But this is the time when they first spoke to each other. Do you see something happen here? Something really fascinating. What does the curve tell you? The curve tells you that before they first spoke to each other, there was a sudden surge of similarity between them. These two people were very similar because of which they spoke, maybe. Because of which they had a talk on the spoke on the talk page, maybe. Do you see? After they spoke, there was increase in their similarity measure. What does this translate to? This translates the following. Because that their interests were common, that's what similarity measure means. Because that their similarity was high, their interests were common, they actually spoke to each other. After speaking, there was further increase in their similarity. This translates the following. Two people become friends if they agree on a lot of, let's say, dishes. In my previous example of me and Priya, maybe if we have 2x7 similarity, we may not become friends. If we agree on a lot of food interests, maybe we will become friends. After, I don't know whether this is true or not, but assume that people become friends because they have a lot of common food interests. What will happen after we become friends? Once we become friends, we tend to have all the more common food interests. We probably will hang out together and eat more often the same kinds of dishes. Give each other our testimonials of this kind of food in this kind of place, and we may want to try these things in each other's presence. So, the fact that we are similar makes us talk. The fact that we have spoken right now makes us become all the more similar. Fine. This plot was given to you for reasons of better explaining things to you. But the fact here is, if you look at the textbook, this plot is the plot of the average. By average, I mean they have looked at all possible people who have actually spoken, and they have observed what was their similarity measure before and what was their similarity measure after. This is the average plot that you see in the textbook, which says that on an average, people tend to become more similar and then talk and then become all the more similar. Not just this. This what's coming next is what makes the research all the more interesting. They observed, I repeat, on an average, people become similar. People, because this is average, I told you, this is average taken over all. Let me write that down. Average taken over all possible pairs of wiki editors who spoke to each other, and we observe that when they speak at this time, there is sudden increase in their similarity measure before speaking and after speaking. This is the average curve. Okay, a mega inference that one can make here is that this is steeper than this. Now that's the climax point in this piece of research. This is steeper than this. Let me write that. This is steeper as compared to this. This is more steeper than this. What does that mean? That means that you become very, very similar and then you talk, and then you continue to become better and better similar, right? So, what is this and what is this? Take a minute's pause and observe what is this and what is this in our language that we are motivating from the past few minutes. Which one is social influence and which one is selection? When do we select? We select when people are similar. So, I'm sure you would have figured out the answer right now. Two people select each other to talk when they are similar. This is selection here, happening on this part of the vertical t equals 0 line selection. And on this part, once they spoken to each other, maybe they will share more common interests and they will start editing pages together. That is what is happening, that is what this means. There is a steep increase in the curve here as well, and this is going to be our social influence. So, we just now saw the plot and we observed the interplay between selection and social influence on a particular type of data set. Now, let us get a little critical and ask this question. Fine, the plot is very clear. It says that initially there is a lot of selection happening here and then social influence is also happening. Selection seems to be more in play than social influence, while both are actually happening. That is with this data set. Maybe this kind of a observation is very context dependent, data set dependent. Now, instead of taking Wikipedia data set, if I were to take some other data set, let us say the way smokers become friends with each other, maybe there is a lot of social influence factor there than selection factor, correct? And in fact, obesity research says otherwise. Whatever we saw here, it is the reverse of that. Here there is more selection than social influence, while in the obesity research what we inferred was there is more social influence than selection. This is a very context dependent observation that people have made. In fact, this opens up brand new questions, namely which is more in play in the society. Right. So, be it with for bad habits, is it more of social influence than selection? For good habits, is it selection and less of social influence? One can ask many such questions, and thankfully we do have some data sets on which we can experiment these questions and then find our answers.